So how many here have dealt with comparison? Like comparing yourself to other people and you seem to always come up short? Yep, trust me, it happens to everybody. And when you keep doing that, it can compound and it can really, really negatively impact. All right, if you guys are new here, my name is Brandy Morgan and we talk about all things freelance, working remote, personal branding, and creating the life that you want outside of a normal 9-to-5 job. Today's video, we are covering 10 things, 10 techniques that I have used in my personal life to help me deal with comparison and low self-esteem, especially in this online world that we live in. Please be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, greatly, greatly appreciate it. Let's jump into the video. So first off, what actually causes low self-esteem or comparison? Like how does this whole thing, like negativity ball start? For me personally, I would consider myself a pretty self-confident, high-esteemed person. Not always, but I've worked on it. I've incorporated these 10 things and it has really helped me not compare myself to other people and just overall make me feel good about myself. But I think it can come when things happen in our life, different events occur. So I've shared this in another video, but just this month in 2020 during COVID, I actually suffered a miscarriage. If you don't know what that is, please Google it. I'm not gonna explain it here. But going through something like that, losing a baby, losing a child, it really wrecked my self-esteem. And then I would go on Instagram primarily and TikTok and I would see these people with these perfect families and all these people getting pregnant, having kids, these people having like multiple kids. And it honestly, it destroyed me on the inside. It was so hard for me to find happiness for those people. But I have incorporated a lot of the stuff I'm gonna go through today to share with you on how I've dealt with that, because for the past few months, I've been doing just fine. So hopefully these tips, you can bring them in as you need and sprinkle them out throughout your life to hopefully help when you go through things that are difficult that are gonna get you down. Because there are things in life that are just gonna pull you down. And we need to make sure that we have tools set up in place so we can fight back when those negative thoughts start coming in. So number one, the first thing that I would say is unfollow the people on social media that trigger those negative thoughts. I went through and I actually unfollowed almost every single celebrity. There, I think, are a few that I still follow, but for the most part, I had to say goodbye to the Kardashians. I couldn't follow them anymore. That especially was very, very triggering, whatever it was about their content. And just in general, I've had to follow a lot of other people that aren't even celebrities just because their content to me was triggering. It was giving me negative feelings, you know? And at the end of the day, it's your account, it's your social media. When you're consuming content, that really, really impacts you as a person. So you need to be careful about what you are consuming. And for me, when I went through that miscarriage, I really had to sit down and tell myself that it's okay to unfollow people. And if people get upset, just tell them, hey, I'm just sorry, I'm going through a lot right now, I'm just kind of focusing on me. Because I unfollowed a ton of different people. Do what is best for you when it comes to social media and the people that you're following, and just get rid of the people that are either being negative, they're not there to help you win, they're not supportive, or just in general, their content isn't adding any value to your life. Because that is one of the quickest ways to start comparing yourself when people post photos. Oh my gosh, it looks like they have the perfect life. Even though it's just a photo or just a video, it's like a sliver of what their life really is. So get rid of people on social media that aren't adding value. Number two, journal. I journal almost every single morning. I do forget, or if I sleep in, I don't actually do it. But for the most part, I journal Monday through Friday for sure during the week. And what I do when I journal is I read in my Bible, I'll write down the Bible verse, and then I'll also write down 3 to 5 things that I'm thankful for. I call it my daily dose of gratitude. Reason why I started doing that was because I was falling down into that negativity pit, A, from comparing myself to other people, and I think just not feeling good about myself, the low self-esteem. So I had to start reminding myself in written form all the things that I have in my life, because I do have an amazing life and I need to be appreciative. And when you start being grateful for the stuff that you have, it really like softens your heart and kind of opens you up more to see the good that is actually out there instead of always trying to find the negative. Because if you go looking for negative things, you're gonna find it. It's just a world we live in. This also really helped. I mean, it took a few months after my miscarriage for me to get back into this, but it was getting dressed and getting ready every single morning. I have jeans on, you can't really tell, but make one. I work from home. This is where I work, where you guys hang out with me every week. This is literally where I am. My bedroom is right over there with my husband. His desk is right there, but this is where we work if we're not at a coffee shop. And yes, I get dressed every single morning, out of my PJs, out of my robe. I try to always put on jeans and a sweater because it's usually cold in here because Josh loves to crank the AC. I always get dressed. It does something mentally for you. Somebody probably knows like the scientific thing behind it. But for me, it's like, okay, boom. It's a check mark off my checklist right away in the morning. Get dressed. The next thing is get ready. Whether that's putting on some mascara, some lip, whatever it is, doing your hair. Oftentimes my hair ends up in a ponytail because it's so long and thick, I need it off of me. But I do get ready Monday through Friday. I get dressed, I at least do something to make myself feel good. Because even when I'm on calls with clients, it just sort of adds to my confidence. Because I'm ready, like I already have achieved something for my day. It's like that quick instant gratification. So that's something that I 100% recommend doing. Get ready, get dressed for your day. Limit the time that you spend on social media. This kind of plays in with the first one that I recommended, but just watch yourself. Be aware of the constant scrolling. If you are somebody that doesn't feel good about yourself and you're comparing yourself to everybody online, scrolling Instagram, scrolling TikTok, watching YouTube video after YouTube video, it isn't gonna help, because at some point you're gonna come up shorthanded when you're comparing yourself to somebody. It only works two ways. Either you're better or you're worse. And if you're already not feeling good about yourself, you're probably gonna be here when you compare yourself. So just take some time off social media, limit yourself. I actually downloaded this game. This is not a plug, but if you didn't know, I'm a huge Harry Potter fan. So I downloaded this game. And it's kind of like Candy Crush, which I was never into. But for some reason, I love it. I spend more time playing that game than I do on social media now. I still would rather spend time on a game like that that's really fun and enjoyable to play than scrolling on Instagram. And something, obviously, if you follow step number one or tip number one and you unfollow people that are triggering, that should also help. But I strongly suggest limiting your time on these types of apps, because at the end of the day, just like I said, when you compare yourself to other people, you're either gonna come up winning and on top, or you're gonna come up losing. Like, you're either gonna be better than them or less than them. So it's just never a good place to be regardless. Stop complaining and appreciate how lucky you are. If you were able to wake up on your own, breathe on your own, see on your own, talk on your own, eat on your own, walk on your own, you are lucky, you are blessed. There are people out there in the world that are less fortunate than you, less fortunate than me. Every time, I feel like since this whole COVID thing happened, it really made me think about how lucky and how blessed that I am to have already had a job that was remote. And then you have these people that don't, like they don't have the ability to go to work. So just stop complaining. Whatever it is, if you're complaining about something, if you don't have as many followers on something, or you're not getting the clients you need, but you still have a job, be thankful and be grateful. Be grateful for what you do have. This is something that I did a long time ago, but it's really helped me. It is embrace being lonely. And while you are in the process of doing that, reinvent yourself. When you are spending time by yourself, because if you're doing something that you need to change your life, like getting rid of friends, which we're gonna cover, it gets lonely. because you're the only person that's in charge of your life. Embrace being alone, embrace feeling lonely, and while you're doing it, just focus on working on you. Drown out the noise of other people, drown out the noise of social media, and focus on you, and be okay with being with just yourself. That's something that I feel a lot of people struggle with. I've been on my own for a really long time. I moved out of my parents' house when I was 17 years old, and I've lived alone for many, many years. So it's something that I was okay with, but I know a lot of people aren't comfortable. Embrace being alone, embrace that quiet time that you get to spend with just yourself. The next one is spend time with God. I know some of you probably aren't Christians on here, or you don't care about God. For me, I get it. I've been there. I come from a family where my dad was a pastor, but I strayed away from God for many years. It wasn't until I was an adult that I realized, okay, there's something to this God thing, whatever it is, but there's this intimacy and almost this power that you get when you establish a personal relationship with Him. It's like you have Him always behind you, always in your back pocket, cheering you on. He's always there to talk to you. He's always there to comfort you. He's always just there. Spend time with God, get to know God. If you have questions about God, I'll try my best to answer them. For me, it really just started with picking up my Bible and reading my daily devotion. That's how I started, and it has 100% changed my life. I wake up excited to read my devotional. I share it every day on my Instagram story. I feel like a lot of times God can be this like mysterious thing, and a lot of people don't know how to approach it. And it's really just like, hey God, what's up? Like, let's talk. It's just a personal, how you would talk to your normal friends is how you can talk to God. That's my biggest thing. It's just a personal relationship that you have with Him. It's between you and Him, and yeah. Number eight, I kind of briefly touched on this one, but get rid of people that just aren't good for you in your life. For me, I had to move 1,500 miles away from everybody I knew to start over so I could be by myself and I could actually figure out who it was that I wanted in my life. Be extremely picky with who you spend your time with and who you give your energy to. Somebody said, I don't know who it is, but it says that you're the sum of the five people that you surround yourself with. If you're looking at those five people and you don't really like their characteristics, or you don't think that those are good people, well, you're probably in the same boat as them. So it's a good idea to do friend checks, meaning evaluating where you're going in life, where they're going in life, and if it matches up, because you want people around you that are going to support you, that are going to push you, that are going to encourage you, that are going to motivate you, inspire you. You don't want to be around people that are going to drag you down, talk crap about you, or think what you're doing is crazy, and just really not support you and not believe in you. I've had to say goodbye to really close friendships because all they did was talk crap about what I was doing online. When I believe in it and I was having fun doing it, I still have fun doing it. But at the end of the day, like, you have to make those decisions for yourself because you're the one that controls who you allow in and out of your life. Number nine, commit to your goals. Commit to what it is that you are setting out to do and do not look back. Do not, you can question it, but do not go say, oh, this is what I want to do, this is what I do, and then you start it and then you quit because something has come up or something has happened. For me, my goal was to become a software developer, specifically in mobile apps. I packed up and moved 1,500 miles to Florida to Full Sail, to attend Full Sail University right down the road, and changed my life. And I went to class every single day. I had perfect attendance. I did not look back. Was it hard? Yes. Did I want to give up at times? Yes. Did I think it was impossible? Yes. But I didn't give up. And I did not look back and I did not question what I was going after. So come up with a goal that makes sense for you. Make sure that goal also has a timeline on it. And start from there and start planning out how you can achieve that goal in your timeline. Number 10, this is something I brought up in another video that I did about 15 habits that changed my life, and it's figure out your strengths and weaknesses. If you are dealing with comparison, low self-esteem, you need to figure out what makes you awesome. you know, and build upon that. Focus on your strengths. There's a book that you can find, I'll pop it up here, that gives you your strengths and weaknesses after you take a test. There's a ton of free ones too. I think there's 16personalities.com. There's another Enneagram personality traits test. Those are free that you can take that are gonna give you some hints at to where your strengths lie and where your weaknesses are. Stuff like that I think really helps people because you kind of know where you're going to excel, and so you can kind of jump into those roles or figure out what jobs would fit best with those roles. 16personalities.com is a great one because I believe it also gives you lists of job types that would be great for that particular personality. And all of the tests take like, I don't know, 10 to maybe 30 minutes. But dealing with comparison, dealing with low self-esteem, it's something that a lot of people deal with. And you deal with it differently in different seasons, and it's gonna hit you differently in different seasons. And different things are gonna trigger in different seasons. But hopefully this list of 10 things you can pull from in those different seasons or in those different times, and they can really help you. Like I said, earlier this year, I suffered the worst possible defeat that I honestly think that I've ever faced. And these things have helped me. I feel so much better. I 100% trust God's decision and God's direction for my life. And when we're supposed to have kids, we'll have kids. At first, when I was dealing with that was not what I was thinking at all. All I kept thinking was, poor me, I was complaining. So you have to go back to that step and just stop complaining and find out why you're so lucky. I'm so lucky because I have an amazing husband who really, really, really loves me. We have a roof over our head. We have running water. We have the ability to work remote, work from wherever, go see my family, go see his family. So always check yourself, gratitude check yourself, give yourself that daily dose of gratitude. Start from there. I promise you it helps. It's helped me tremendously. All right. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Once again, please give me a thumbs up. Don't forget to share this if anybody needs a reminder and needs some help with comparison and low self-esteem. I'd greatly appreciate it. Leave me a comment if you have any questions or suggestions for videos. I'm always open to it. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I hope you guys have a great day.